we need a clutch.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking with that smell.
Look at all this fancy.
Fancy, yeah.
Look at this fancy stuff. Don't ask us why we're taking a new car home.
Oh, God.
Someone has Caitlin at gunpoint.
Don't shoot!
No, don't do it.
No, don't do it. There's just so much light in my eyes.
Say hello, Caitlin.
Hello, Caitlin.
What are we doing? Tell them what we're doing.
We're moving the bus to my parents' house.
Woo!
Woo!
Why is that exciting?
Because we're going to be able to do the stuff and stuff.
We're going to renovate. We're gonna shorten this closet. We're going to put in our wood stove. We're going to paint the bus. A lot of exciting things are happening. And then I think at the end of that, we're going to find a mechanic, and then we're going to head fucking west. It's about damn time.
Yay!
Would you say?
Does that work?
I don't know. That's a drain plug gasket. I need the oil pan gasket. Also, I think I might do an oil pan gasket. At any rate, we just got done putting the bus together. Chip's going along with Sarah this time. She brought her car. Founders in with Caitlin, along with Keycat. And here's Simple Rick in all his glory. We made it.
Woo.
Super excited.
Ow.
Guess what? You want to tell them what you just did?
I just set an appointment with a mechanic.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi.
And we're going to go tomorrow?
Thursday.
I don't know what to say.
Two nights.
Okay, cool.
Bye. You too.
Look at that bus. Sarah and I are headed to King's Ford to pick up Caitlin's mother's vehicle. She had some service done on it, and that's where we're going. I'm going to drive it home. So whenever we move the bus, I'm always left with the task to put the bus back together because we have too much stuff. And when we move, we have to move a lot of things that are in precarious positions to the floor so that they don't break, don't slide around, don't bang around, mess things up. So while we're here at Caitlin's parents' house, we're going to be making an effort to minimize that necessity via getting rid of a lot more things that we have to move to the floor, because those are the problems. So we'll start there, but it's not going to be easy. Getting rid of more things isn't easy. We've already minimized so many things, and we're still trying to get rid of things. So if I have one piece of advice to you, if you are thinking about bus life in any context, think about the necessity of getting rid of a lot of your things. If not, in a lot of cases, sometimes you have to get rid of everything, 90% of your stuff. But from experience, from having done this and worrying about whether or not it's going to be an easy thing to do, and you know, finding out that it's not an easy thing to do, once you get rid of things, I have found that it is a relief. It's a breath of fresh air. It is a good thing because, well, it's pushing us forward. We're taking steps towards our goals, so we don't need those things. We're not going to regret not having a triple slow cooker that we've never opened for 2 years now. We bought this 2 years ago. I've never opened it. We're not going to regret having got rid of that once we go out and we see the mountains and we see the stars and we see all the amazing landscapes. So my advice to you is get rid of your shit. Taylor's getting ready for work. Bye, Taylor.
Hello.
Good morning. Afternoon.
Is it afternoon?
Sunday brunch.
Yeah, we are having Sunday brunch. This is my first day one of living in the camper,
Day one. We got two roommates, so that is four people, two dogs, one cat.
Can't scratch his eyes out. What the hell?
We
Are they done now?
Yeah, I shifted, and now it's done.
That's a good boy.
But Caitlin just left for work. That leaves me with the task of minimizing our stuff. We are going to be leaving here soon, and actually tomorrow, or the next day, I believe, we will be taking the bus to the mechanic. So we need to get as much stuff out of the bus as possible. So we're going to be doing our final minimization kind of task where I go through everything, basically take a lot of the stuff out of the bus and then only bring back into the bus the stuff that I believe we will use. We're trying to be more task oriented with our things. So the things that I want to focus on are our YouTube and crafting things. So that be it leatherwork, woodworking, in regards to wood carving and small scroll saw projects. Those are the things that I'd like to focus on in addition to photography and learning guitar. Those are my focuses, so I shouldn't keep anything else. That just becomes clutter if those are my focuses, and I think that's a plenty of focuses to have for the foreseeable future. Caitlin's focus is going to be more on things like embroidery and crochet and paint by numbers and things of that nature. She's also gotten into cooking recently, and she really enjoys baking, so we're going to be keeping things of that sort of focus. For just the two of us, we're trying to minimize as many dishes that we have, so if you only have a couple plates and bowls, you only have a couple plates and bowls to fit clean. We're also getting rid of our refrigerator, so and replacing that with a cooler, because we'll be doing a lot of traveling. We figure we'll be moving the stuff from the refrigerator to the cooler anyway, because we don't have a proper solar setup to keep the refrigerator running. We're using the space that the refrigerator is in as a new pantry, so the cooler will sit in the bottom and then the rest of it will be a nice pantry, which should free up quite a bit of space for our dishes and cooking utensils and what have you, things that are more or less in the way at the moment, because that rack up there isn't supposed to be for cooking things. It's not supposed to be for kitchenware. It's supposed to be for plants. We have plans to put plants up there, and plants have not yet made it to our bus. We're not sure about plants because we're going into winter, so we'll see about we'll see if that becomes just a place to collect clutter or if we'll actually put plants in as planned. Aside from all of that, there's not much going on. And that's really not saying a whole lot because, like, you know, we never have anything going on. Taylor has made headway on his camper. We got it started yesterday and even got it into drive. We were having trouble getting it into drive. We figured it was a fuel delivery concern, so we replaced the fuel filter and bypassed the fuel tank into a Dasani water bottle, and then but we were able to get it started and it ran fine. But we found that trying to get it into drive, the brakes were seized to the drums. So our next venture there, probably later this evening, will be to attempt to get those brakes unseized. We're not really sure what's going on with the camper though. Hopefully he'll be able to move it into it soon, get it to Ford to get the work done that needs to be done, and then move into it. I think he's excited to finally be able to do that, and we're excited for him as well.
Blueberries.
Those are all blueberries underneath our counter. We give our dogs blueberries because they happen to be a nice, healthy, cheap treat you can give your dogs, but every once in a while we either knock them out of the fridge or just drop a bunch. Well, apparently, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, roughly 12 of them have been lost and been drying underneath our counter. This is all donating, being donated. That's all being donated. This is all donating.
No. Wrong. Most of the stuff that he showed isn't getting donated. Most of the stuff over there is. We're gonna try to sell these things for another week.
Are we?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's about it.
Alright.
Well, we gotta get through that pile right there. That's the end of it. These three boxes.
Okay.
Well, JoJo. These three boxes and then this pile.
You gonna put JoJo inside? She's whining.
Look at all the shit. Look at all that shit.
Where are we going, Caitlin?
We're going to Goodwill.
Going to Goodwill, huh?
I'm relieved to get rid of this much stuff. But there's quite a few things in here that, like, it really pains me to just be like, throw it away, get rid of it. Because, like, it's stuff that could totally
be stuff.
Be stuff for a while longer. Like, my stuff. But it doesn't make sense to keep stuff. So we don't. But I guess, overall, I'm happy about it.
How much stuff are we getting rid of?
This whole car full.
And then how many more car fulls?
Probably at least one more. My mom doesn't even... I'm gonna get a freaking ticket because she has a headlight out.
Oh, no.
I should turn around and tell them that we're not going anywhere.
Yeah.
The headlight. That would be the smart decision, but I'm not gonna do that. Because I know that they laugh at me. I'll just make them pay the ticket. It wouldn't add points to my license.
You're funny, Caitlin. You're cute. You know that?
It's a little stressful about everything that's happening this week. But I know that, like, that's obviously the plan. Everything's going accordingly and everything's fine. It's just kind of stressful. Donation center hours, Monday to Saturday to 8 p.m. 8:21.
All right, well.
We're definitely not getting the shot because my mom's going to do this for us. We're not coming back to do this because tomorrow we've got a full day already.
Oh, yeah. We've got a full day ahead of us, so I guess it wasn't in the cards today taking the Goodwill stuff. Well, spit happens. We got to see a nice sunset. It's really pretty.
It's still really pretty.
It's still really pretty. Yeah, and we're going to get Dairy Queen.
Yeah.
This is a venture well worth having.
Free Dairy Queen.
Exactly. That's the perfect Dairy Queen dance. Free Dairy Queen. Wow, what a woo.
Can you call my mom and ask her what the fuck they want?
Hello?
Hey, I didn't get a text with any flavors.
Okay, Dad's sending it right now.
Okay.
Are you sending it right now?
Okay, just so you know, you looked up the hours for Goodwill, the store. They stopped accepting donations at 8 p.m.
Just like you said.
That's what I said. So we're on our way to Dairy Queen now. Okay.
Beat him, you can cheat him, you can treat him bad, and leave him when he's down here.
Ready for you. I'm standing on my own 2 feet. Out of nowhere, the bullets rip. Beat it to the side of the beat.